Recording.
Thank you. So,
That's not the...
No, we didn't.
No. Some of you sang with the composer of Homeward Bound in a virtual choir. She came on and sang alto for a couple...
Yes.
Yeah, that's Marta.
She's your friend in Las Vegas.
Yeah, this too makes it about 10 grand. Yeah, and it's become very renowned. It's a great memorial celebration of life tune. It wouldn't be bad for homecoming either, to tell you the truth. And yeah, so it's nice. We'll just run the numbers, and then what time we have left over, we'll throw on the Hallelujah. How's that sound?
Yeah.
I have no idea what else is coming down the pike. I want to welcome Lisa back.
Yay!
Lena, are you going to be here Sunday?
But she did come tonight. So
they're on vacation.
No, this is a skeleton crew that's getting us into summer. That's all right. We have an on chat.
It pays to have Danero.
You know what happened to that on chat?
They don't drink in really types.
Oh no, Rosie will be here on Sunday. She couldn't make it tonight.
She just came to one of
those. Somebody in Indiana at the hotel kept everybody awake. She only got 1 hour of sleep. She landed this morning at 11, and she said, there's no way. I'm going to be dead by the time you guys start. So,
you never fly anything on the day
you fly. You can never fly.
Unless you're the conductor.
Well.
Right? We don't get those luxuries. All right, let's open with Spirit of Life, warm up, blah, blah, blah.
Oh, Spirit.
And I wouldn't mind doing this a cappella if we could on Sunday. That would be nice.
Spirit of Life?
Did you pull Spirit of Life off the table?
Oh, it was there, but
I don't know mine.
Yeah, man.
Okay. Okay.
Butterfly Benediction was another piece that was on the table. check out in the folder. Does everybody have butterfly?
No, I do not.
My 3.5 measure benediction. I know you do. That's one of the reasons I chose it.
Well, don't get too deep. I said since March, we've had to buy a new refrigerator, a new microwave, and today a new dishwasher.
Yikes, it's the year of appliances for you.
And our dishwasher was 8 years old, maybe.
The prices are stupid, aren't they?
Yes, sorry, sing.
Man.
I'm talking.
Okay, here we go. Supposed to be short and sweet. Does everybody know this one well enough to do a cappella? Or shall we review the alto for you?
Yes, please.
Okay, here we go. Altos by themselves, please. 1, 2, 3, 4.
May you go.
Up until the end of measure 14, it stays two voice. Then it splits into three voice at the end of 14. Here we go. Can we get a beginning note? Oh, it's the bottom one of those. Okay.
Thank you.
take it from the top of page 7, measure 53. Can you wait till I count us in? 1, 2, 3. That's my ideal job.
What does that mean?
Sit around, huh?
Making up music. Did you say she's a staff composer?
She was. Yeah. And Hal Leonard.
Oh, for music.
Wow.
What else do you compose?
You didn't say it. You just said publishing company.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I said staff composer. So, let's do it again, shall we? I think two more times through this, and we'll have it. So, tenors? What glaringly stood out to me was the dotted 8/16 pickup to the line. Just about every one of them, we squared it out to 2/8 notes.
Oh,
yeah.
The in-law.
So at the very beginning, it goes 1, 2. In the quiet, not in the quiet.
Yeah, it's just fast.
And it's happening like it pick up to 11, like in summer, and then, you know. A couple of places where they're major phrases, they are 8 notes, but you've got to keep your eyes peeled to see which ones are and which ones aren't. So that was the only glaring thing that jumped out at me. plus that magnificent pitch acquisition at the end.
Good.
All right, here we go. 2, 3.
In the quiet, misty morning, when the moon has gone to bed, when the sparrows stop their singing, then the sky is clear and red, when the summer ceases to
set me free.
Yeah.
So if we can keep that phrase mark, especially the back row. You notice you have a slur going from the B flat to the A flat, and then from the A flat to the G. Could you play that to the plow, set me free, the bottom line? Just the bottom line. Start from measure 21. Yeah.
We haven't been breathing on that one, so.
Yeah, but it wasn't smooth. Just thank you, son. Can I hear the back row from the pickup to 19 at the bottom of page 3, please? 1, 2.
I mean not to the pasture.
Back row, same place, pick up to 19. I, 1, 2.
I be not to the pasture, shame me not to the plow, set me free to
thank you. I would like to give that a little swell. On from plow to set me free, just a little one. Maybe going from, well, in this vernacular, we're at forte. Let's give it a little push. We're at forte at 19, so maybe a fortissimo, and then bring it down a little bit. There it is, a decrescendo at measure 24 to a mezzo piano. Okay, can I have all voices at that place? Actually, before we do all voices, can I have the front row do that? Pick up to 19, bottom of page 3. It's an octave. 1, 2. Chris had single copies of Chris Nelson, and he had. There's a whole lot of them still in there. Big, big boxes, of just one single copy.
I guess everybody.
So I pulled this one out. I'm not even thinking about
it. This is a strange place to take a breath. Should we be
shedding? Yeah, except that if you look at it, your last breath was right where we started, right before that pickup.
What?
I'm sorry. No, after right before chain. Right before chain me, the pickup to page 4. So at this tempo, that's quite a breath. Okay?
Keep that going.
See if we can keep it. See if we can do it. And it involves taking a huge breath. And I know most of us don't think that way. So fill the tank. Fill the tank. So can I have all voices at the pickup at 19? I'll give you 1, 2. 1, 2.
We have some other music by Jay.
Oh yeah, we do. He's a good arranger. I don't really have a problem with that. It's just, you know, I'm just being a butthead. So let's take it from the pickup to 29, please.
Okay.
Bottom of page 4. Yes, everybody. So before we do that, could you play at 32, the second measure on page 5, that half note? Could you play that half note for the sopranos and altos have? Okay, altos. The soprano note is your note on the notes. Okay. Okay, good. So let's run that a couple of times till it gets smooth. All right, so from the pickup to 29, I'll give you 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, let's try it again. I did say that, didn't I? I'm getting old. love playing the age card. It's great.
Yeah.
Can't play it here.
Sure I can.
All the time.
Watch me. Here we go. One, two.
If you find it's me you're missing, if you're hoping a return, do your thoughts I'll soon be last
way. Hold on.
I just can't get that freaking sleep.
Okay, can I have altos by themselves from the same place? But it sounds like you don't have the shape of the line after that.
Right. But I have to hit the C. You have to hit the C because the sopranos are singing. So it would be helpful practice.
Yes? Is that it? Can we hear just the alto line, please? From pick up to 29. Front row. Can we just have the front row, please? One, two.
If you find it's me you're missing, if you're hoping for return, do your thoughts or else you'll be missing.
Good. Again? Can I just run that phrase? Can we just run that phrase? I know you want to hear the C and you will. Let's just run to your thoughts, I'll soon be listening. I'll give you one, two. Can you give me the C and the E flat, please? One, two. Everybody pay them the lead. One, two. Good, all right, one more time. One, two. That was the one I was waiting for. Can we go back and do front row only to pick up to 29? One, two.
If you find it's me you're missing, if you're hoping I'll return, do your thoughts I'll soon be missing.
Good. Again?
Yeah.
Merrily, when we get to that section where the back row drops out, can you give me just the alto C? Give me the alto line on. Okay, here we go. Start again. One, two.
If you find it's me you're missing, if you're hoping I'll return, do your thoughts I'll soon be missing.
Good. Again? Again? Strength, it's pitch acquisition, as we say in the business. Okay, I'm doing the weather check. When the clouds start moving really quickly, we'll be out of here.
Okay.
Can I have that starting note again? You don't really expect me to hear that volume, did you?
No.
Oh, okay, thank you.
I have a lot more than
I want. I always want it. You never use it.
I sure do.
Not when you talk to me if you're in the back row during choir rehearsal.
Okay.
See?
I'm trying not to sound like
here we go. Front row, please. One, two.
If you forbids me your missing, if you're
solid it in. Get it solid. Okay. Here we go. One, two.
If you find it to be your missing, if your the sun.
do ambiento there? Ambiento? Ambiento? Can we fade to a zero?
Fade to a zero.
It is.
Can we take it from the pickup to the 4-4 bar, please? Let's close the end and then fade it out. Let's dive into it. Yeah, this is a sort of confusing beginning. Yeah. So let's try it. Just that bass, tenor, and alto.
Seven?
No.
Sorry,
it's already in seven. Oh, yeah, seven would be good. Top of the page, top of page two, third measure.
That's all I
need. Yeah, so bass and tenor are unison there. One, I'm going to slow down a little bit. One, two, three, four. Looking forward to find the rhythm of those eight notes, right? Eight note rest. So can we pick it up from the end of measure six, the pick up to seven, where we just started the lower voice of the sopranos? Can you give me speed four B? Okay. Can I have that G? And then the rest of the notes, altos, or tenors and basses are together.
No.
Measure six, the pickup to measure seven. Speak for me, sopranos are by themselves. Yes, can you sing it, please? All right, here we go. I'll give you one, two. We're down a little bit in tempo. One, two.
Speak for me.
Somebody was singing. Well, I didn't hear the B flat. So can I hear those notes again, please? At 25. One or three, four, one. That's great, thank you.
Why do we have a tenor clef in the first place? Why do I have to read completely different notes again?
Yeah. Actually, when the parts are in four lines, it's traditional to use tenor clef anyway. For the third line. It is. You will rarely find a four-line configuration where the tenor is a bass clef. No, there's no transposing, it's just reading treble clef.
Right.
It's not a transpose. I mean, transpose is taking it into a different key. You just have to read treble clef? Wait a minute, did you play clarinet?
I did, but my fingers aren't playing right now, it's my throat.
It's not your fingers or your throat we're talking about, it's your brain.
Yeah, well,
okay. What'd you say, you don't have one? Sorry, it was right there.
This is why I
drink. Oh, you're way too
good. You're sitting here with alcohol.
Okay. You know, it, we, in kinky boots.
Oh my God, that's score.
I had to read tenor clef in one in my left hand and treble clef in my right. I've never had anything so frustrating in piano score. Just, oh, it was just awful.
Heck, when you weren't there and I had to play their parts with them, I did the same thing. It was annoying.
Oh, man. Okay. Let's take it from, let's take it from 21, do that intro again, and then go into the where the bass is solo. Top of page 4, measure 1. Ah. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, can I point out to you, Pam?
Yeah, it's on the same note as before.
Yes. So, a little memory there.
I'm sorry, I just...
No, it's okay. It's a new piece. Don't apologize. It's fine. You're supposed to lose your way now. Okay? Again, same place. 1, 2, 3, 4. Can we take it from the bass solo entrance, please? Pick up to 25. On page 4. I'll give you 1, 2. 1, 2.
Let the friends of the friends.
Tenors and sopranos, are you guys having difficulty with that half note at the beginning of the triplet? Are we clear on the rhythm there?
And I lay down my heavy
hands.
So it's, and I lay down my heavy load. Sustained through the first two and then...
Yeah, and
okay,
they're short.
Good.
The heavy is, the Y is short.
Can we just speak that line, and I lay down my heavy load? And those of you holding it, say, those of you who are not holding it, pulse the triplet. I'll give you one, two. One, two.
And I lay down my heavy load.
Good. Good. Now can we sing from...
bass all over?
Yeah, bass pick up again, please. At the top of page four, last measure. One, two.
Let the friends of Oh,
practice on that. I'll give you 3-4-1. 3-4-1. To a C?
Yeah.
That's a C? Okay. So it's one. Again. 3-4-1. Again. 3-4-1. Good. Can I hear sopranos and altos together on that? 3-4. Trying to get this phrase down because it begins a new phrase anyway. All right? So, yes. Sopranos go, lay down, even though you're tempted to sing that C because your run ends on the C. All right? But you don't. And the altos will go, 3-4-1. Lay down. And that's why we ran it. So let's try it. Can we do it together? Or do we need review? Okay, here we go. 3-4-1. You're going to the C, Pam. I'm sorry, you're right. Okay.
I take the E flat.
You take the E flat? And then consequently, the G and the A flat.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Thank you. Can I have the upper voices one more time through the end of that line? Sopranos and altos. From Let Them Speak for Me. 3, 4, 1.
Let them speak for me.
Can you hear the background? From the basses, speak for me. Are we leaving?
Yeah, we can't
do it. And we have 2 more pages to go.
I'll do the rest of my piano. Okay?
Sure. Back row. From second measure, speak for me. I want to test your breath control. Yeah, all right, you don't need that. We don't need that. All right, so at 41, B3. I just thought it might be easier to get into it. So, Liam, you're going to continue on that E flat.
Yes.
Easy. I'll give you 1, 2. 1, 2.
Oh,
Yes. Should not be a dotted half note.
It looks like a dot.
It does. It does indeed.
I think that's like a misprint on there. That's like a continuation of a line.
Actually, it looks like an ink spatter. Because if you look at that dotted corner at the beginning of the line, it's a much heavier dot.
Also, one thing I need to point out, on 44, it's sun, not aw.
True enough.
44,
the
it's
kid
sun.
Calls it, it is sun.
Oh yeah, sure is.
How about that? All right.
How about that? Sorry.
Tenors, one more time. One, two.
Thank you.
25 is shaky on the soprano line, and I just figured out why. Could you play that chord at the beginning of the last line on page 6?
Son.
Please.
Measure
45. That's why it's hard. It's a ninth chord.
It's a
ninth chord. A dominant ninth chord. A minor ninth chord. A dominant. It's not a dominant, it's a minor ninth. Right? Missing the fifth. That's why it's weird. So, that E flat. Listen to your triad. Let's take it from the same place again, and then we'll call it a night. Speak for me. One, two.
Speak for me.
Throw the tenors all over the place.
I get it there, I get it there, getting new jeans. What are you guys doing? Oh, God, that's... violas play a five line system that has the C in the middle line. So I'd like to establish it that first Sunday is your day off,
okay,
unless I give you notice otherwise, and I will always try to do so at least 2 weeks in advance, which means next Monday's rehearsal is about gain, volume, and the abdominal wall.
Okay.
The use of volume and the abdominal wall. Sounds like a book I should tell you.
Well, for Labor Day, I have to stay with my students under 16 at their house tonight because Memorial Day weekend, when they went camping without me, had a big fun. So now I'm there as a supervisor, but there's no big because the barracks are gone. Oh, Labor Day weekend, I have to stay. Though they just live off the skyline where all my grandkids live. The one who's 16, I have to stay there nights because Memorial Day weekend, he had a party. 16-year-old.
Oh.
So I'll take him out to some nice fields or
I was going to suggest carrying baseball.
Oh. No, I don't know. That's what they both asked me if I stay. They don't want to drag him camping.
They don't want to
drag him camping when he doesn't really want to go to Amazon Lake. So he'll just stay home and be supervised at night by his grandma. And it'll be good. Then they don't have to take their dogs camping. They can just stay at the house. And the big dog doesn't have to come stay with us.
Dogs are good to take in.
Yeah, but why? Oh, well, Beck is a dog. Oh my God, he's adorable. He's a blue tick hound mixed with a full-size Australian Shepherd by accident, but he is he's beautiful. And he is totally, he can run, with Rory, the one who's 13, he jumps barriers and he'll do anything with her. They just had a dog show up at you know, the...
Liam, did you stop the recording?
What?
Did you stop the recording?
Oh, I didn't know.
Okay.
Okay, so
what?
We'll have extras.
I just noticed something.